We can use Scratch to help us learn Python. Today we're looking at lists. Let's start off with what we know in Scratch. What can we do in Scratch with lists? Well, we start off by creating a list in data. So we can make a list, we give it a name, and that gives us these blocks that we use to change things with the list. So we can start off by adding items to the list. So here we've got a list called week, and we're going to add days of the week. So we can start off by typing each day from Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. We're only going to go up to Friday in this example, but you can see we can add items to the list quite easily. So let's add Thursday. You can see, so we can add items one by one to a list in Python. So what else can we do? Here's our list. You can see we have five items, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What happens if we want to delete an item? Well, delete, we can delete the first item. Now we've got 1, 2, 3, 4. But did you notice Monday was deleted? So if we add Monday, that will go at the end of the list. So the delete one deleted the first item. We can change that to delete last. So now the fifth element, Monday, is gone. And if we want to put Monday at the beginning, we can use insert. So we have insert Monday at number one in the list. So our numbers, we can use 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 to know the place of the item within the week list. We can use replace. We have the first item, the last item, also random. So if we wanted to replace the last item to Saturday, for example, that would change Friday to Saturday. So if we go back to our insert, let's delete Saturday and insert Friday as number 5 in the list. So now we insert, and now we have our list. We have our 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. Now with lists, you may often loop through a list and have a look at each item. If we do that, we use the length of the list, and also we need to look at each item. So let's use a loop. We can use repeat loop, and we're going to repeat the amount of how many items there are in the list. So that's the length of the list. So week has 5 elements, 5 items, so we're going to repeat it 5 times. Now, when we go through the loop, we want to identify each item. So here we're just going to say the item in the list week. But we want to say each item. So rather than say item 1 or the last item, we want to say item 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, then 5. So we create the variable count, set that at 1, and change that by 1 when we go through our loop. So we're going to say the item number 1, then item 2, item 3, item 4, and item 5. To make that clearer, we're just going to join. So we're going to say the actual count, which is going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, plus the item in the list. So number 1 item is Monday, number 2 item is Tuesday, number 3 item is Wednesday, number 4 item is Thursday, and number 5 item is Friday. So in Scratch, we can do a few things with a list. We can access different items in the list. We can add items and delete them, insert them, and replace them. So now let's have a look at Python. So we can create a list by using just square brackets. Empty square brackets will create create an empty list. Or you can say equals list, but remember these are round brackets. So either way, we'll create a list. To add an element, an item, at the end of a list, we use dot, append, and then what we want to add in brackets. So here we've got a list called a list, and then we add the number 10, and you can see the list is just the number 10. So let's add another number, 20. We run that, and here you can see we've got 10 and 20 in our list. If we want to create the list first, instead of making it an empty list and adding one item at a time, here we've just created the list, a list with 10, 20, 30, 40 and 50 already in the list at the start. So now let's see what we can do with this list. We can see the length of the list. We know there's 5 items, so we can use len, L-E-N, and in brackets our list name. So you can see here when we print it, it prints 5. So that's handy when we do our loop, for example. So what else did we do in Scratch to our list? Well, you can see we added items with dot append. You can see also if we want to remove an item, we can use pop. If there's nothing in brackets, pop will remove the last item. So we have our list name dot pop and in brackets with a number. Now look at this, pop 0 takes out the first item. So if we use a number inside pop, then that will remove, delete, that number. But why 0? If we print a list and 0 in square brackets, meaning that's the number, it prints 10. So our list of 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 is in fact not 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, but it starts at 0. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So if we access the item in the fourth place, it will give us 50, and in the second place, give us 30. Can you see the numbers there? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So item 0 is 10. The item at number 1 index is 20. Number 2 index is 30. So if you look again, we've got pop 2. So that's going to take out the number 30, the item at the index 2 out of the list. So that's something very different from Scratch to Python. It starts at 0, not 1. If you know which the name of the item, like the value of the item in the list, you can use remove as well. So here we want to remove the number 40 from our list, we can use that with dot remove. Again, the value that we want to remove, we put in the brackets. So here we can remove 20. So the things that we can do in Scratch, we can also do in Python. Here we try to remove 0, it's not there, so it gives us a value error. So if you try to remove something that's not there, then that's wrong. So we can also insert. Now if we try to insert something in Python, it's going to say, wait a second, it takes exactly 2 arguments. We've only put in 1, so we've put 100 in. It wants to know where we want to insert our value. So we're going to insert 100. If we put it at 0, it will insert it at the beginning. If we say, let's say number 3, it will insert it at the place of index number 3 and move the other items backwards. Can you see that? 10, 20, 30, 100, 40, 50. So we can insert it, a value, but we need to tell it the value and where we're going to insert it. So if you're going to replace an item, you can just use the index. So you could say a list 0 in square brackets equals 20, and then that would replace the value 10 with 20, for example. Now let's have a look at a loop. Can you remember in Scratch we used a count to access each item in a list? In a for loop we can already do that with just for item in a list and then just print the item. Now let's explain what happens with the index. So we're going to start off with count. Count goes starts at 0, we add 1 each time. So we're just going to print each item with 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 in front of it. So you can see that count will go from 0 to 4. So that should be straightforward. Now, if we put a list with square brackets and count, so we're looking at the item at that place in our list, a list, what's it going to print? Well, place 0 will print 10, place 1 will print 20, up to place 4 will print 50. Remember, we go 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, not 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we've got count, which is 0, and a list 0 is the item with the value 10. So we go a list 0, a list 1, a list 2, a list 3, a list 4. Now, if you want to use the length of a list, if you don't know how long a list is, you could use range, and range will go from 0 to the length of the list but not include the last number. So for 5 it will go from 0 to 4. It will go from the first element to the last element. So that's handy. We want to access each item in the list. So here we've got for I in range, so this will be same as range 5. So range 5 would give us 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So the length of a list in this case is 5. So that will give us 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So I is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. And a list value is 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. So there you can see how we can access each element with the index. Now let's create another list with our days of the week. We had Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday and Friday. Notice these are strings rather than numbers, so we have these double quotes, or you could use single quotes. So now we're going to access each item up to the last item by using range and length, and then we're going to go from 0 to 1, 2, 3, 4, and that's going to access that item in the list. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, if we remove an item it will go 0, 1, 2, 3, so it will change depending on the length. So let's review what we've just seen. So here we've got range, to length of the week. So if that was 5 items it would go 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So we can print X, which is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then the item in the list called week at that place. So week 0 would be Monday, week 1 would be Tuesday, week 2, Wednesday, week 3, Thursday, week 4, Friday. That might be quite difficult to grasp straight away, so you might need to watch some parts of the video a few times to make sure it's clear. Because the list starts at 0, that makes it a little bit more difficult and different from Scratch. But the things we did in Scratch, we are now doing in Python. Okay, thank you for watching. And if you haven't already, please subscribe.